Hello from San Francisco. This is Harry Bro and Paul Aguilar on the camera work. And we're in the Castro neighborhood in here in front of the Community Health and Wellness Center of the San Francisco AIDS Foundation. It's a wonderful neighborhood and it's been the center of long-term survivors for many, many years. Today, we're going to meet one of those long-term survivors, Vince Crisostomo. Hi, Vince. Thank you for coming and joining us, and thanks for showing up to share about long-term survivors. There's so much we can cover about this. Is there any particular points that you'd like to hit?
Well, you know, we just passed July 3rd, which is the 39th anniversary of the article in the New York Times that kind of hinted of what was to come.
Wow.
You know, for a lot of people, the last time the International AIDS Conference happened in San Francisco was 1990. So it's like history is repeating itself. You know, we have a lot of reform about the police. There's a lot of, there are many issues around human rights, Black Lives Matter. And I don't know, it took a second pandemic, COVID-19, for people to figure that out. Mm. But I'm hopeful. You know, I am hopeful that this time it will make a difference. In my time, you know, I've done my work here in the U.S., I've done it internationally, I've done it across in the state, in the towns, and you don't often get a chance to get things right, and this time I think we do. The fact that we have so many young people taking to the streets who are actually willing to die for this, you know, there's so many things happening with COVID-19 that it really ups the ante. And while COVID is similar, it's still very different. And 39 years later, we have a chance to really make that difference. Eliminate bad leadership. You know, bad leadership is bad leadership. And we have had to live, you know, I actually think that's worse than living through the pandemic, though I don't know if you should quote me on that. But we can only hope that people, you know, that this is not right, that there is a responsibility that comes with power, and that we need to hold those people who hold that power accountable.
Wow, that does cover a lot, absolutely. I'm trying to think, is there a, we're doing well. The long-term survivors that you know are doing well to the best of your knowledge.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we've benefited. I mean, there's so many things. There's U equals U, which means if you are, undetectable, you cannot transfer the virus to someone else. There's so many things that we've seen in our lifetimes that I didn't think we would see. The approval of gay marriage, the U.S. Supreme Court just ruled in favor of employment rights. There's so many things we have to be thankful for. And I think for myself, so many things that we have to be hopeful for the future.
Excuse me, Vince, but we've run out of time for our session today, and I'm so grateful to you. You've shared some important points, and I'm so glad. So from me and Paul here in San Francisco, it's thank you very much, and back to Amsterdam.